Today, Jovi is learning all about an event that turns trash into treasure. He is in Vancouver to tell us more about the Recycled Arts Festival. Joe, good morning.
Hey, good morning, Kim. Yeah, Kim, so last time we saw you, we had Joseph Brady working his magic. You remember he had 8 pencils going at a time here working on a caricature. Now it looks like we've down to 1 here. Where are we at in the process, Joseph?
We're down to 1 pencil where I'm putting in some key black parts. Mm-hmm. After that, we'll be doing some paint.
It's been really fascinating, Kim, to see the process. As you remember, he was scribbling frantically
right. With
about 8 different pencils, doing the eraser, now the finer points. So keep working on it. Get a mental picture of what I look like. We'll revisit you here in a second, Joseph, because I want to introduce some of the other artists. We'll be right back. Should mention we're back here at McCord's Vancouver Toyota. They're the main sponsor of the Clark County Recycled Arts Festival. Now, I'm joined by Wayne and Leonard Deaton. Good morning, gentlemen. How are you?
Good morning.
And they are a father and son team, and you guys do recycled art.
Everything is recycled. Okay. Everything.
So, Wayne, tell me a little bit about kind of what you guys work with. Because everything that we look here, it had some prior use, right? I mean, this is all kind of found stuff.
It is. This fire pit here was a air compressor that was on a construction site that somebody cut a hole in it and said free. And I threw it in my truck, brought it home, and now it's a fire pit.
That is beautiful.
Lord, you were telling me... Isn't that amazing, Kim? And so it all started, Leonard, you were telling me, you used to weld way back when this guy was just a little youngster, right?
We've welded for 60 years.
And you eventually taught him and his brother how to do this, and then you guys started turning it into art, essentially, right?
Well, my brother and I, we used to make Christmas presents, birthday presents, and then we got older, got out of it, and then just 20-some years ago, I just started making more Christmas stuff for people, and then...
Dad got looped into it.
Oh, yes, definitely. And retired and had fun.
There you go, and you got a shop full of stuff here. So let's talk about some of these other items. So this little piggy right here, it looks like, you know, the expression, when pigs fly.
When pigs fly.
That was made out of an old, what, propane tank?
Derelict propane tank.
And tell me a little bit, Wayne, about some of the your pieces that you have over here.
Old crescent wrenches that don't hold anymore. I've made into lizards, fishing guys there because I like fishing.
Some of the pieces like this right here is it's a grasshopper that you can, I guess, you know, fix your toilet with if you need to, right?
You can.
There you go. All right, so functional art. You can see them right here at the Clark County Recycled Arts Festival. It'll take place Saturday and Sunday at Esther Short Park. Gentlemen, thank you very much. Do appreciate it. I'm going to head back over here, show Joseph one more time. Guys, I've got a little more modeling to do, but coming up in our final segment, we're going to unveil the finished masterpiece here as we get you ready for the Recycled Arts Festival. Strike a pose. Back to you in the studio.
Oh, I can't wait to see the finished product. And you know, it's interesting. You pick up these wrenches and these other tools for 50 cents to a dollar, mm-hmm. you know, at a garage sale or something like that. And then you make this beautiful art out of it and sell it for a bunch of money.
Yeah,
so it's great.
It's good stuff. And they enjoy doing it, too.
Yeah,
it's a win-win all the way through
Hobby. Nice hobby.